It's okay. Grab the stringer for that as well.
Somewhere.
Should have a big spool of white
string.
I think it's in the next one down.
Okay.
I'll use this up.
Yeah.
Yep, there's more.
Oh, yay.
Wow, do you want the white at the top and the green below? Or does it matter? It doesn't need to be super tight. Just yep. I don't like launching in the snow. I've done it before. We went to snow. I don't think so. We did a snow.
I've done it never when it's snowing, but I've done it when it's pretty dang cold.
We've done it where there was snow on the ground and we had to stomp it down. And when the snow we launched, we did it anyway.
No, thank you.
In other words, I'm not available that day. Okay. Now, unfortunately, we're going to be looking at some of that in January, February, I'm sure. But, and we won't have, it'll be our own crew, because I can't bring all the teachers are allowed to come in. But I can't do it. All right.
Morning.
Morning. Oh, what you need there? I was doing
well,
Jonas is research. And we have to get up. We have to get up to that. We do get some stratosphere. Here. We can see if the temperature, we get a temperature change.
I'll bet.
We start seeing the temp, you know, temperature drops to about negative 50 degrees Celsius or so. And
yeah.
Then it starts coming back up, and that's the, actually the mark of the stratosphere. But anyway.
Uh-huh.
So then we're up there about the temperature. Another common blue is probably really cold. We've got about 9 years of data that we've been collecting from all our flights. So my line is 2011.
Yeah.
I can't believe that sometimes. I mean, Doug got no loop.
That's why.
Yeah, that's probably the hardest part to realize. Yes. Okay, come on over. Let's scoop this up. Today the winds are such that if it follows a predicted path, and there's a, they're actually predicted, it will, it's gonna parallel I-70 from here to Florida.
Get up into the wind aloft and really go.
Yeah, when we were looking at Sunday, I think we were looking at Sunday for flight or Monday originally, we were gonna end up here. We've got those storm fronts coming through,
right?
And so we'll start out here. We're getting up before the wind pick up today. But up there, we're going to hit the jet stream, and we'll watch this thing start falling about 60, 70, 80, 100 miles per hour. I think the fastest we've ever been is like 150. But on the ground, I remember being with a high school group, middle school group, kids can track with the ball. They're going, look how fast it's going. It'd just take off like a shot. That one ended up 40. So
how long will it stay up?
It's roughly about 2 hours. And we've been fortunate the last few weeks, back in the beginning of October, where it was kind of mild, we didn't get much major weather. So we were able to let the weather up above the wind, and we ended up landing. Really, about 10 miles away. Whereas here, we're going to be closer to 90. We've gone as far as 120 miles. So today is
a more typical fall watch.
Okay.
So when I was in high school, I did this with hydrogen balloons.
Oh,
put,
yeah.
I put postcards on, and I got a postcard back in my phone. Down that direction. Yeah, it was fun. I did probably a dozen or more balloons. And got one postcard.
Wow, I went to high school.
Yeah, well, that's all I could make at home.
And if you get more bang for your budget, you will get better with. And it's cheap.
Yeah.
Really, this is expensive, but for us, we recovered, but we've got a. And Gigi, I guess you're ready.
Yeah, we're all
tied up. So what we have, payload-wise, is a radio transmitter that's going to give us a position and altitude, and then a digital spot that'll actually give us some ground landing spots. So we'll go with it ourselves. Unlike the Weather Service are doing what you did, you know, just let go. Technology has changed.
Oh, yeah.
But the satellite piece is a good one. All right, I think we're about ready. I can hold it.
Okay.
Oh, yeah, it's just going to get loud. You know what? I forgot to get parking lot.
Ready?
Yeah, the doctor had told me and asked me to fix my tinnitus. He said, yeah, I'll go back 20 years. It's a little late. Okay. That's a really helpful doctor. It's this. We usually try to get about 3 to 4 pounds positive lift. But the trade-off is if we overfill, then we lose out of the three strap lift. Although last month we got 93,000. Yeah, the best we manage is 103,000, which is way up there. But our goal today is the scientific that I've been trying to do some just to get us to 110. The views are beautiful though. We've got cameras running. This is cold.
It's gonna be cloudy, overcast all the way to
won't be seeing much of the ground. We'll get jumped to change in. We'll enter the game. Okay. I need somebody to hold this while I'm fine.
Would you take that pipe out or leave it in there?
We're going to take it out in just a second. Going to slow us our altitude down today. We're going to pass after that cloud event, I just put up. Projected for, and I'm gonna check to see if we got our radio. Let me check. Should the radio should be showing up?
Yeah, I'm gonna check.
We'll give it a couple.